let's go through the wireframes for the Settings UI. Within the Detail activity in the Overflow menu, there's a Settings menu item. When you tap on the Settings menu item, it opens up the Settings activity. If you tap on Location, it pops up a dialog where you can enter in your postal code. Feel free to use your preferred method for inputting location, such as city name. Just verify that the data coming back from the server is for the location you expect. Note that there's no validation on this string input. If you're trying to make this app a production app, you would want some type of error handling here. If you tap on Pick Your Units, it opens up a dialog where you can choose to display temperature within the app as either metric or imperial units. This is basically just Celsius or Fahrenheit. And that's what the settings activity does. Remember that you don't want to make everything a setting. If you're discussing a feature with a teammate and you can't decide on something, don't compromise by just making it a user setting. There are instances where making a difficult product decision now will be better for the user because then they don't have the burden of having to decide what the value of the setting should be. And remember, there's always an opportunity in an app update to add the setting later. If you add it to begin with, it's infinitely harder to take away the setting because some users might get angry with you. If you're having trouble deciding if something should be a setting or not, you can check out the settings section in the Android Design Guide, which is linked below. It contains a workflow diagram that could help you. Very few roads often lead to making something a setting.